Hello YouTube and fellow preppers, I am Geordie Prepper. Today's video we're looking at HandBrake, which is an open source program, and the video is for YouTube content creators. If like me, you had problems with large audio and video files, the video that you were uploading to YouTube was taking a very long time to upload due to its file size, are currently getting a very long time for the video to process by the YouTube servers, then I hope that this video helps you out and introduces you to a program here called HandBrake. The link to the website will be in the description below. It's for many platforms. It's for Windows, Mac and Linux, and this is a program that you'd use at the very end of your video production stage. So this basically converts the exported file from whichever video editor that you use, be it iMovie, Final Cut Pro. If you don't have a lot of options on the export process from those programs, then using HandBrake in your post-production stage just before you upload the video should give you some things to look at and should help you with the file size, and it should lead to some very fast processing times when you're uploading the video itself. So let's get into the tutorial now and I'll take you through it. So basically what I have here, it's just a test project. All I did was I filmed 7 minutes of basically an LP spinning around, as you can see here. The LP was just a Pink Floyd album. And, you know, this is just a test reel. It's just, imagine that you've assembled your video in the movie editor that you use. So, I mean, I just use iMovie. I'm based on an Apple Macintosh. So imagine this is the video that you've created and you're going to export it for use onto YouTube. So there's the video. It's pretty boring. It's just an LP spinning around. We've got to fade out to black. And then we're going to export the video. The video was shot in 1080p, so be sure to select the 1080p resolution. We're going to output it at high quality. You can see here the file size is 770 megabyte estimated. Once you have selected your save location, just click save. You'll then get an estimated time that it's going to take to actually write the file, and I'll skip ahead until it's finished. So the movie has exported now. That is your finished video that you're going to put into YouTube, and it's at your export location. And you'll note the file size. Now it's worth, when you're creating content, to look at your original video and see how big that was. So we see here it was 1.36 gigabyte. Now obviously you're not going to use all of your files in the finished product that you've got. So it's very likely that the exported file will be smaller than the total sum of what all of your videos make up. So make sure that your exported final project is smaller than your, you know, the total sum of all the file sizes of all the videos that you use to create the content, because if your exported file is larger by a significant amount, then there's obviously, you know, maybe perhaps you've exported it at a higher resolution than what the video was made at. So the test video I made, it was a 1080p on the camera, and I want to make sure that when it's exported, it's at 1080p size. So we can double check that in QuickTime. And what we'll do is we'll just look at the movie inspector. So we see here that the format is H.264, which is basically MP4, and the file size is 1920x1080. The audio is in AAC, which is an Apple compressed format. Sampling rate is 48,000 hertz. It's in stereo. The frames per second is 30 frames per second, which is what I shot the video at, and the data size is 769 megabyte. There's one important thing to note here, and that is under the format section, and that's the sampling rate that the audio is in. And this will be related to the audio section that we cover in the program itself. So when we go into HandBrake and we're creating the file which we're going to upload into YouTube, we're going to go into the audio section, and it's important to make note of the sampling rate there. Audio is an often overlooked thing in videos, and it can increase the size of the file quite significantly. So far what we've done is we've exported the final video product that we're going to upload to YouTube. We've checked certain attributes of it and the size. It's in 1080p, and we've also looked at the audio and we've seen the sampling rate that that's recorded in. And what we're going to do now is we're going to use HandBrake to prepare that file in a way which is a lot easier to upload, and it makes the YouTube servers to break down the file and to process it quicker than what it would do if you just simply uploaded your file without going through HandBrake. So when you open up the program here, you don't normally get that window. That's the queue. So you'll be presented with this window here. Now, I've already saved some presets, so you'll see them down here. There is some preset settings in here which you can use, and you can select it just to, if you're going to create a video and you know it's going to be for the iPad, you can just simply click the iPad setting, and you know it'll put in all the options there to make it suitable for an iPad. But I've already created some settings here, and they load up with some of the options which I've pre-selected. You have the source button here. It'll basically open up a sheet, and then that's where you select the video that you've exported. So once you've found the exported video, you simply click on open, and it'll load it into the HandBrake program. Next to it is the start button. That's going to start the process of encoding it into the format using the options that you select later on. Pause, that can pause the process when it's exporting. Add to the queue. Now it's best to show the queue first. So bring up the queue window. And add to queue is what you're going to do last. Next one is the picture settings. So if you click on that, you get some options up regarding the picture settings. Now when you bring up this window, make sure you check the very bottom of the main window. The source, it tells you the size of the source, and then the output. You can see that the output is selected for 720p. So what we need to do in the picture settings is just change the width to a 1080p, and it should automatically change the height to 1080p. Then the next thing to do is to make sure that there's going to be no cropping. Select automatic and just make sure that all these settings are zero. If any of these settings change, custom. If you click on custom, you know you can change the settings. If any of them change, then you'll notice that this number here changes. So as long as these two are the same as these two, you know that your video is not going to be cropped. So we'll put that back to zero and automatic. And you can see there that the values have changed. Just make sure that anything you do, you just put back so that the video is going to output correctly. That's all you basically need to do in the picture settings window, but it is worth doing that as part of your export and preparing your video as part of the process. The video codec has already been selected for me. The format, and this is the important part for uploading to YouTube, make sure that when you set up your default settings that you set up once you're familiar with the program, save your settings as a file, as a default setting. And the format here is very important, that you select MKV. The frame rate, we just keep the frame rate the same as the source. And this section here, I don't really bother with this section, but you can alter it if you really want to. And that's just basically to put a constant quality. Now, if you want to retain the very best quality, it basically, adjusting this slider, like it says here, it adjusts the encoder settings to trade off between compression and, you know, the quality of the video and how fast it's going to encode it. So it defaults to fast, but I mean, I usually put it down to medium just so that you retain more of the quality of the outputted file. That's all you really need to do in the videos tab, but One of the important bits, which is related to an earlier section of the video, when you click on the audio tab, just check these parts here, because the two bits that you're going to be looking at is the sample rate and the bit rate. Now, what you know from earlier that the sample rate of the video was at 48,000 hertz or 48 kilohertz, and most computer devices and in fact CDs, their default is 44.1. So like I was saying earlier, audio is often a very overlooked part of a video when people make videos. There's no point uploading anything with a sample rate higher than 44.1, because the audio equipment that 99% of the people are going to be listening to it on simply can't do anything higher than that. So there's literally no point in selecting anything higher. There's also, for the opposite reason, because you'll lose quality, there's no point going below 44.1. That's automatically going to reduce the size of the audio track, and therefore it's going to reduce the overall size of the file once it's been encoded by HandBrake. Also, the bitrate, you'll want to knock that down to 128 kilobits, because similarly, like the sample rate, you know, you're not going to notice much of a difference between 160 and 128 on most of the equipment that 99% of the people are going to be listening to it on. It doesn't affect the volume or the gain of the audio track at all. It's just simply the compression that's going to be used, and you know, the bit rate that's going to downsample it to. So change the sample rate to 44.1 and the bit rate to 128 kilobits, and then you're done in that audio section. The only two sections I bother with is sample rate, bit rate in the audio section, and in the video I've already set up a preset so that it defaults to these settings, but you know, just double check them and that's it, you know. But the important one for the format is to compress it into an MKV file. And the reason for this is the YouTube servers, if you upload an MKV file, it basically splits that file into many parts and it distributes them throughout several servers, or as many servers as it thinks it needs. And then when it comes to processing the video, you have many, many servers which are processing lots of little chunks of your video, and then YouTube puts them all back together, and then that's the processing done for the whole thing. Once you've done that, like I said, the last button that you're going to click is the add to queue, and there you see your file is added. Obviously you could add many, many, many files, and you could just run them all at the same time. So you press start, and then at the bottom here it shows you the progress of the encoding. Obviously I'm not going to sit here for 5 or more minutes, however it's going to take. So we'll come back when it's finished and I'll show you the finished product. So once you've added the video to the queue and you've pressed start and the video's encoded and finished, you'll see that there's a green tick next to it, and it's multi-threaded and you can do other things whilst it's running. You know, you can still work on your computer and you can add more videos to the queue, which as you can see I did here, and these are just the screen recordings which make up this video. So if we look at the exported file, which we did from the movie editor, so this is the actual raw file, you'll see it has a file size of 769.1 megabyte. And then if we look at the HandBrake optimized MKV file, you'll see that it has a size of 189 megabyte. So that's obviously a significant reduction. And if we just open up both of the files, now I do have some video effects on VLC running, so basically I'll just switch those off for now. And we'll just look at the files side by side. So that's the original MP4, and this is the HandBrake optimized file. And let's just go to a specific point in the video. There isn't that much difference between them. And obviously you can fine tune the settings so that you produce something as close as you can. Let's go to 1 minute into the video. And let's just look and see if there is much of a difference. There shouldn't be. It shouldn't be a significant difference or a difference which you're going to notice. Unless you're really critical and you're really looking for it. There still seems to be a video effect on here. Let me just turn it off. So as you can see, I mean, there's very little difference between them, if any. But obviously, this file size is significantly smaller than the one that you exported from the video program. So I hope you found it very useful. As always, be safe, be prepared, and if you've liked this video, take a look at my other content on my channel. And please subscribe, like, and share the video. And yeah, this is Geordie Prepper signing off.